up, YouTubers? It's Gamer. It's me, Brian Solo, aka Gamer 55551. And I am back with another video. And we're going to be, this is a My Two Cents video. And we're going to be looking at four stories that has been popped up this week. Plus, as a bonus, I am going to talk about a movie I saw this week. And I don't need to say the name because I think this pretty much sums it up right here. Yep. Went to the IMAX version. I will give you my thoughts about it after we talk about these four stories this week. Matching with my red shirt, yeah. Okay, so the four stories we got this week that popped up were game trailers shutting down, no new Assassin's Creed game this year, the Fire Emblem Fate getting so-called the petty mode that we thought was not going to be in the Western version, but it looks like if this report from Nintendo Life is accurate, it sounds like we are getting it, sort of, and I'm going to get to that too. And finally, a non-gaming one, but one that certainly has raised some eyebrows, it's the Twitter's Trust and Safety Council, and some of the response we got from some people who are not happy with this decision, and I'm going to give you my take and my thoughts about that. But let's start with part one first. Let's start with that one first. Sorry about that for a little bit. Someone was calling my name and I had to go check what was going on. So stuff happens though. All right. So why don't we get started with part one of this video and we'll talk about today, which is game trailers is shutting down. Apparently after, I think it was about 13 years, It is shutting down, and, you know, I think it's sad. I mean, I really do think it's sad that, and it's really sad, what even makes it even more sadder is some of these employees just found out about it, and I think that is sort of a disappointment, though. Now, I've been to game trailers before, I've seen some of their stuff. I do like some of their content and some of the stuff, like, I think, correct me if I'm saying this wrong, so I apologize if I'm saying this not right. I think it's the Final Bossum or something like that. Again, I apologize if I'm saying it wrong or anything like that, though. So that was one of the things, though. The other one, of course, is the fact that I also had some of the reviews and everything. And some of the reviews I agree and disagree with. I mean, I had a different take on certain of their games. Some of the controversial decisions was putting in Michael Patchen in here, you know, the guy who claims, guys who makes these predictions, which doesn't always turn out to be true. I mean, we all remember his famous Order 1886 was going to sell 10 million copies. We all know how that turned out, though. So, I will say I am saddened by this saddened that they are closing, though. At the same time, though, it also sort of is a change of the times as well. I mean, a lot of people, you know, we're seeing a lot of, you know, people getting their information, you know, not going to just a site, though, but I mean, you know, people are posting stuff, like, on YouTube and everything, and so, I feel that, to a certain degree, game trailers were not able to keep up with the change of the time. I mean, despite having their YouTube page, it still wasn't enough for them to keep up, though. I mean, I remember 1UP.com. I mean, you remember that. Some of you may or may not remember. I mean, that closed as well. So, you know, I am very saddened by this, though. I really am. And, but, you know, it is a change, though. I mean, it's the change. And I guess a lot of people are starting to get their content or get their information some elsewhere other than just going to game trailers, not to mention, you know, of course, YouTube and everything. So, my heart goes out to the employees over at Game Trailer, though. I seriously hope they're able to find, you know, a job soon and, or at least, you know, find success, you know, in some ways, in some form, though. So, and who knows? Maybe they'll do, you know, what, like what Jim Sterling's doing, do a Patreon and do that. I mean, that would be great if they were able, if some of those guys were able to do that, but who knows? But bottom line, game trailer shutting down, really disappointing and really sad on that one, though. Okay, so I'm gonna take a little break, and when we come back, we're gonna get to part two though. Part two will be about no new Assassin's Creed game this year though, so I will give you my thoughts and my take on that. So we'll take a little quick break, and we will be right back. Done with this little bit of a break, we are now going to get ready for our next part of our My Two Cents video, and for this one it is going to be part two. So for part two though, we're going to be talking about an article that's recently popped up. I'll have a link to some of these stories in the description. This one comes from Push Square, but it's been confirmed through others sources as well that turns out there will be no new Assassin's Creed game this year. And quite frankly, in my opinion though, I think that's a good thing. I mean, look, I think the Assassin's Creed games are fun, but after the debacle that was Assassin's Creed Unity and the way Ubisoft handled that situation, in which, of course, everyone knows they used a review embargo to cover up just how bad that game was, and people found out and they were pretty pissed. They were pretty upset about it, and rightfully so. They had to be upset about it. And then, of course, last year Syndicate came out, and while that game got a better response, and it certainly was a better game, though, from what I understand, it didn't perform as well as Ubisoft had hoped for. So, in retrospect, in my opinion, this is a very good thing, indeed. I think it was the right thing for Ubisoft to do, to delay and not release a new Assassin's Creed this year, because doing an annual franchise, I personally think, in fact, I'm against the idea of annual franchises, releasing them every single year, because I feel it does not give the developers enough time to basically, you know, create something, you know, expand upon and create something new, or fix problems that may have addressed in the first one and all. I mean, we've seen this before with Call of Duty, and while Call of Duty is not slowing down now, I do feel it's only a matter of time before it hits, before that game gets impacted. And I think the Unity debacle really, I think, may have put the brakes on any attempt to release a new Assassin's Creed game. Now, it is February though, so they may or may not change their mind. I mean, I highly doubt they will. I think this is a smart move on Ubisoft's part, because I think Unity was damaged the series' reputation big time, and I think delaying it is a smart move on their part, because I think this will help at least give the developers some time to at least flesh out some new ideas, maybe take a new approach or something like that, and give them time to polish it so we can actually get a good polished Assassin's Creed game, rather than pump one out every single year, and that, you know, with the risk of it possibly being broken, buggy, and all that stuff. So, I mean, overall, I have to say, this was a smart move on Ubisoft's part on this one. Now, whether in the end, if that taking a whole year and then finally releasing the new Assassin's Creed game pays off or not, remains to be seen. We won't know until they eventually announce one, and most likely it'll be released in 2017. And of course, the rumor has it now that in its place might be Watch Dogs 2, though. Now, it's unclear if Watch Dogs 2 will be released this year or not, but if Watch Dogs 2 is going to happen, if that's the case, Ubisoft's going to have an uphill with that one because people remember what happened with the first game, especially the whole downgrading from the announcement trailer and the amount of backlash Ubisoft got when many gamers felt that Ubisoft lied to them. And then, of course, they pulled the graphics aren't important argument, which, for the record, there's nothing wrong with that argument. The problem with that argument is that you sold your game on visuals, and then you tried to retreat and pull that, and people, to me, it sounded like people caught you with your pants down. So, who knows if Watch Dogs 2 will take Assassin's Creed place this year, but if it does, Ubisoft's going to have to work to convince people, why should I buy Watch Dogs 2 when you lied to us, at least in terms of visuals and all, with the first Watch Dogs game? So, it's going to be interesting, but the point is, for part 2, though, for this one, it seems as though we are not going to get a new Assassin's Creed game this year. So, if all these reports coming in are true, and it sounds like it is, then I say that's a good thing, though. At least that's how I look at it, though, all right? All right, we're going to take another break, though, and when I get back, when we come back to this one, we're going to be talking about part 3, and part 3 will be all about this so-called skinship, aka petting, for Fire Emblem Fate, and it turns out it will actually be in the Western version, sort of, and I will get to that and explain that part. So we'll take a break, and we will be right back. So now, I hope you guys, we're back from our break. A little tongue twister right there. Okay, so we're going to get ready and talk about part 3 of our My Two Cents. And this one involves the game Fire Emblem Fate, though. Now, I did a video earlier before when there were reports coming out about some of the controversy surrounding it. And one of the controversy was this so-called petting or sort of or skinship or whatever it's called that would not be coming over, will not be in the Western version of Fire Emblem Fate when it comes out. Now, some people shouted foul on this. Some people were not happy with this decision. Some, I've heard stories of even going as far as doing a change.org petition about it, though. And, of course, Nintendo is, of course, and we saw this with the Xenoblade Chronicles X controversy, where when the character's age was changed to her outfit wasn't shown, to the certain outfit that she had in the Japanese version, was it going to be shown in the Western version, to one of the things when you could create your own avatar, if you choose a female one, you can't adjust the size of their breasts, so that was some of the controversies. And of course, Fire Emblem, the series, is also known for some of it, including Fire Emblem Awakening, when a certain scene was changed due to the fact that when a certain character looked like she was putting on the bottom part of her bikini, a blanket sort of covered that bottom part, which sort of became a joke because people thought that she was bottomless at the bottom, and so on. Well, it seems as though this so-called petting mode or something to Fire Emblem Fate, according to this article from Nintendo Life, and again, this is all the stuff I talk about, it's going to be in the description, and you can read for yourself and take a look at it, though, so I'll have a link to them as well. But it seems as though this petting mode will be available in the U.S., in the Western, aka the U.S. version, though, at the very least. Not sure about the Europe or Australia version, but I'm guessing most likely it will be in there. However, it's sort of, there's somewhat of a catch to it. So let me look this up and try to get it for you guys. Okay, just wait 1 second. All right, so basically, this is based off of person's from Nintendo's life run of it, and according to him, it seems as though you can, it seems as though in order for this whole thing to work, you have to reach an S, a grade S in the relationship with a certain, with your character, though, and you, and that, and you have to sort of, like, boost your relationship or anything. I mean, when you reach that S, you know, S grade or S ship, though, and then, according to this, it says that there is a new private quarter option called Bond, which is basically the same as Invite Alley, but with a heart meter that tracks how you bond with them. Every so often, this meter kind of event triggers. And according to what this person says, the first and only event I've seen so far was my S ship fell asleep, so I poked at them awake on the touchscreen. I mean, now this is based off a person's playtime with it and so on. So it seems as though, according to this article, assuming this is correct though, it seems that this, the mode that we thought was going to be taken out of the Western version will still be in the West, will be taken, will still be in the Western version for Fire Emblem Fate. However, according to what we now know, is that that in the Japanese version, you can invite anybody anytime and perform this certain petting or so-called skinship. I believe that's what it's being referred to. Again, all this is in the I'll have a link to the description. You can read it. However, if this article is correct, it seems as though that for the Western version, there's sort of a catch. There's sort of, the catch is that you can only do it at a certain time. I mean, a certain time and a certain place to do it. And it looks like you can only do it with one character in terms of who you're building your relationship up with. It doesn't look like you'll be able to do it with any character like it is in the Japanese version. So this is kind of interesting, that the fact that this mode will be in the Western version of Fire Emblem Fate, despite what we thought it was going to be taken out or anything. Now, whether or not you agree with their decision to do this or not, again, remains to be seen. But I will say it is kind of interesting that they are bringing it, putting it in the Western version, and I'm glad that it doesn't look like they'll be taking it out. So still, I mean, it is an interesting thing that they are doing this, though. And again, as I said, I have a link to the description before, and also another article with it about the whole localization thing as well. I mean, it's very interesting. I mean, take a look at it and read it yourself, though. So overall on this one, it looks like we are getting this so-called petting minigame, skinship, or whatever the hell it's being referred to. So again, I have a link to it with the others, also with the other stuff I talked about as well, so you could take a look at this, read it yourself, and sort of, you know, come to your own conclusion whether you think this whole skinship or petting minigame is good or not. All right, so anyway, this concludes our part three, though. One last break, though, and when we be back, we are going to be talking about part four, and this is about Twitter's decision to do this whole safety council thing. And see what, and give you my thoughts about it, and then tell you some of the people's reaction to this, okay? So we will be right back. folks. I hope you enjoyed the last break that we're going to be doing. And so we're going to be getting to our fourth and final story of this one for this video. And this one is going to be the Twitter Trust and Safety Council. Now, as some of you may not know, Twitter has started this whole safety council thing in order to preserve, prevent people from, like, you know, the whole cyberbullying and death threats and everything like that. Now, there has been some criticism about this for lots of reasons, though, and I'm going to get to a lot of this. I know this is going to be a little, I know some people have already stressed their opinion about this, but I have gone to the page and take a look at some of these groups that are part of this Trust and Safety Council thing, okay? Now, as Alpha Omega Sin, a YouTuber who I respect for, believe me, I do, and Monday Matt, if I'm saying his name right, again, another YouTuber I respect for, have given their opinion about this, and they're certainly not a big fan of this, okay? And, again, I have a link to their videos, and, of course, you can take a look at their videos and see for yourself whether you agree with their views or not, though, okay? So, I have, and let me get it out there, okay, I have taken a look and looked at some of these groups that are part of this so-called, this whole-called council members, this trust and safety council group, though, all right? One of the groups I am familiar with and is the Anti-Defamation League, it is, and which fights anti-Semitism. And as a Jewish person, I think that's a good thing that they are fighting a lot, the anti-Semitism that unfortunately does exist in the world. It's sad that it does. It is. So I've took a look at some of these groups, though, and here's my take on this whole situation. Here's how I'm looking at it, okay? I don't disagree with some of these groups, though, okay? Now, hear me out for just a second. I'm going to put one of the groups that's already on here that we know has certainly caused a lot of headaches, so I'm going to put them aside, and I will mention them. Don't worry. So, hear me out for just a second. I don't disagree with some of these groups. It's like the Anti-Defamation League, and I don't disagree that cyberbullying and death threats do need to be dealt with, though, okay? I don't disagree with that, though, okay? I do agree that it does need to be addressed. That said, though, at the same time, I am also a firm believer of freedom of speech that does apply to the internet. I believe the First Amendment does apply to the internet, and I believe people should have the right to express their views online, no matter how ridiculous or way out there it is. And while the attention of what the Safety Council is trying to, while I don't disagree with the idea, the whole Trust and Safety Council, I understand what the attention is, but I just feel it's a disaster just waiting to happen. Especially, and I'm going to put this group in now, especially when you have Feminine Frequency and Andy Sarkeesian in here. That is a red flag right there, though, considering that Andy Sarkeesian did go to the United Nations and preach about censoring the internet, which, no. As a person who believes in free speech, and as a person who believes that free speech should apply to the internet, that I do not agree with, and I believe, and I truly do believe this is a disaster waiting to happen, because one example are that we've seen in cases where some people have used on YouTube, however, filing false copyright strikes against people they do not agree with, though, all right? We've seen it in case against Total Biscuit with Day One Gary Survival. I think some of you Total Biscuit fans probably are aware of that one. Jim Sterling fans, again, I respect Jim Sterling, even though I do not 100% agree with all of his videos, though, but still I respect him, especially with the whole Skate Man Intense Rescue and the so-called, you know, slaughtering ground, where a lot of these developers filed false copyright strikes in order to silence a credit, though. And I feel that while I don't disagree with the causes of some of these groups, minus Feminine Frequencies, given their reputation, though, I think this is just a bad idea, because what's going to stop someone from, like, if they're going into a discussion about something and it's a respectful discussion, some person in this group could basically say, oh, that's, you're offending somebody, we're going to delete or censor that person. So, and given Feminine Frequency and Andy Sarkeesian's history, though, I just am not, think this is a bad idea, or at least the way it's being done, okay? Again, don't get me wrong, I believe cyberbullying does need to be addressed. I believe harassment does need to be addressed, though. So I'm not saying that this shouldn't be addressed or anything, but you sort of have to sort of strike a certain balance with it, though. You got to do it in a way that doesn't censor people's right to express their opinion and express their views. And having Feminine Frequency and Andy Sarkeesian's history, especially when she went to the United Nations and saying that the internet should be censored, that to me is kind of a bit of a red flag right there. And I think this to me has all the makings of a disaster waiting to happen. And for the record, Andy Sarkeesian is not the only person to say that as well. People on the right have also done this as well. So they're not immune to it, though. But Andy Sarkeesian is the one who's got the most attention. Now, I will defend Andy Sarkeesian's right to free speech, but I will also defend people's right to, you know, criticize Andy Sarkeesian. And if somebody decides to give a respectful criticism, okay, not a death threat or anything like that, I'm worried that members of this Feminine Frequency group will abuse this in a way to censor that person. And again, like I said, it really is a bad idea. And given some of the criticism, it will be interesting to see how this Twitter Trust and Safety Council goes, though. Whether this ends up people, you know, not using Twitter anymore, or how big of a backlash this will generate or not. I mean, already, you know, as always, as I have linked in the description, though, Alpha Omega Sin and Monday Man has given their thoughts about this, though, okay? And obviously, they're not big fans of it. Not to mention, both Alpha Omega Sin and Andy Sarkeesian sort of have history of, you know, going at each other's throat. Not literally going at each other's throats, though, but while I don't share the same outrage as those two, I definitely understand their point of view on this. And I do agree that this, to me, do agree that this has all, as I said, I may be beating the dead horse for saying this, but I do agree this has all the makings of a disaster waiting to happen. Okay? We'll have to wait and see how it turns out, but right now, if this is handled poorly, which I have a bad feeling it might be, though, then it'll be interesting to see how long this stays, how long the so-called Twitter Trust and Safety Council stays up, though. I mean, some of these groups, like the ADL, Anti-Defamation League, I mean, I support their cause, though, but I just feel this is just, there is some concerns about the way this is being handled. I mean, it's the same way, kind of way I felt about when the whole SOPA law came out. I agree pirating should be addressed, though, but it should not come at the expense of censoring people's right to express their opinion online, though. And as I pointed out with the YouTube, I just have a feeling it can easily be abused big time, though. And, alright, so before I end this video, I do want to, as I said earlier on, I do want to talk about, of course, try to end this on a positive note, though, Deadpool. And I will have to say, I saw it, as I said, I saw it in the IMAX, though, mostly because due to time-wise, I wanted to sort of find the right time to see the movie, though, and normally I don't do IMAX movies, but time-wise, this was the best option available for me, at least where I live, though. And I will have to say, I like the movie. It was funny. I mean, I really enjoyed it. I think Ray Reynolds did a great job playing Deadpool. I mean, he definitely, the character, I understand that when he was in X-Men Origins Wolverine, that wasn't the Deadpool people want, and I don't disagree, but I did feel Ray Reynolds, the actor was there. It was right there. It was just, that wasn't the movie, though. And I think now this is the movie, of course, we all wanted to see Deadpool, though. I mean, it was funny, though. There were certainly scenes, especially with Colossal, though. I mean, and there were certain parts that were basically funny, though. Other parts, there were jokes that were funny, but just nowhere near the laughter that was with the Colossal scene. I don't want to spoil it for those who haven't seen it yet, but I will say in conclusion, though, that this was, of course, you know, the Deadpool movie that I think Deadpool fans wanted, though, and I think we finally got it, though. So let's make this one for Deadpool fans. Let's try to make this movie a success so that we can get the sequel going, though. I think, and been judging by the predictions, if some of the predictions in the box office are true and so on, though, then I have a feeling that we will see a sequel. And I am definitely, even though I'm not a diehard Deadpool fan, I'm definitely open to seeing Ray Reynolds play Deadpool again. I mean, I definitely like the fact that he's playing that character, and I also felt the marketing was great. But bottom line, the movie was good. I recommend if you go, worth seeing, though. And I'm glad 20th Century Fox stuck with their guns and made this an R-rated movie, despite the Change.org petition to try to turn it into a PG-13 movie, though. While it is possible they could have done a PG-13 movie, and I do mean just possible, though, okay? I'm not saying they should have done it PG-13. I'm saying it's possible they could have done it. I will say, after seeing the Red Band trailers and some of the marketing for it, though, I just can't see how they could have done it in a PG-13 way. I mean, I'm glad they made it R-rated. So I don't think it would have worked as a PG-13 movie at all. So it would not work. So again, I'm beating a dead horse for saying this, but go see Deadpool. It's a good movie, though. And of course, it's being that it's out on presidential weekend. If the movie does well, like I said before, if it does well, we're going to get a sequel. So good. And I'm glad 20th Century Fox did not, pardon my language for saying this, but what the hell, fucked it up like they did with Fantastic Four reboot did. Thank God they did not screw this one up, though, all right? Anyway, this concludes my review of this, I mean, not review, I'm sorry, my mistake, my 2 cent story. So, and again, these are my opinions. Well, what are yours, though? For part one, are you disappointed that game trailers is gone now, that they are shutting down? Were you a fan of them? Or do you think that, or do you really did not care at all? You really are not losing sleep over that game trailers is gone, though. For part two, are you pleased that we're not going to get Assassin's Creed this year? I mean, or are you somehow disappointed you wanted to see Assassin's Creed game this year or not? So are you happy that they're not bringing one this a new one this year, or are you pleased about that? For part three, are you satisfied with the fact the way that the Nintendo is going to, in terms of this whole skinship or petting mini game in Fire Emblem Fate? Are you happy that it's coming over here to the West and not being censored, or you really didn't care? Are you happy with the way they are handling it, though? Or do you think they should have just stuck with the way it's set up in the Japanese version? Or you really don't care in either way? And finally, the last one, the Twitter Trust and Safety Council. Do you believe that it's not as big of a deal as Alpha Omega Sin or Monday Matt are saying it is? Or do you think they are spot on about it, that this is a disaster waiting to happen? Does this impact you using Twitter in any way, or it does not? Are you going to take a cautious approach about it, or do you feel like I said before, this is a disaster waiting to happen at all? And then, of course, last but not least, Deadpool. I mean, did you enjoy it as much as I did, or were you not a big fan of it, though? And was this the Deadpool movie you wanted, though, what you always wanted? as always, sound off in the comment section below and tell me what you think about the four things, even the Deadpool, my thoughts about the Deadpool movie as well. What your thought about it, whether you agree, disagree, or have a different take on the situation. As always, I hope you liked the video. We would really like if you hit that like button, though. And I do hope you do subscribe to my YouTube channel, alright? Alright, well, I will say this concludes this My Two Cent video for talking about the stories that have come out this week that I thought were very interesting, though. And I hope to see you guys again next time when I do my new video, alright? So, it's evening right here, so I'll be getting ready for bed and all, and I will hope to see you guys again soon, okay? Bye! Go see Deadpool. Go see Deadpool. Where is it? Right here. There we go.